Looking to turn some old cards into new fetch lands? Check out ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We've got ferociously competitive prices on cards new and old, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you'd prefer to pick up singles, boosters, or even a battle box, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order, and soon you'll be rolling in villainous wealth.
Hey, this is Pat Cox. Welcome back to another Origins draft here on Channel Fireball. So we opened some pretty good cards. I don't know how to say this card's name, and I'm going to try, but this Elf Lord guy is pretty great. I'm not even actually sure that it's better than Seismic Elemental. This card is just totally insane. Like, the low side of it is a 4-4 for 5, which is perfectly fine in this format. Creature's really small. And the high side is you just win the game, and there's obviously just plenty of in-between. So this is probably the best card in the pack. Waracle's pretty good. I think it's worse than Seismic Elemental. And then you even got some pretty good commons. Free Blade, Unholy Hunger, Claustrophobia. I don't know. I mean, this is a powerful card. Haven't played with it a ton. Yeah, I don't know. You're kind of locking yourselves into not only... So you're not only locking yourself into green, but potentially even black if you're trying to get the full bonus out of that. Now, if I had picked that, I probably would just, like, picked this elite and kind of gone all in. But since I didn't, I think I like Thief. Thief is a lot better than this card just in general, so... Alright. I do immediately regret my pick, though, because I got a sweet Elf Uncommon second. Yeah, so I think, well, the best card in the pack is Cruel Revival. Claustrophobia certainly goes with our last pick more. And they're not, like, super far off. I mean, this is definitely better, but you're not guaranteed to be getting a zombie back. Like, it's an extra card some percentage of the time. I think I like just taking the card that goes with what I already have, even though it's a little less powerful. Ooh, another Seismic Elemental. Alright, well, I don't regret my green pick anymore, because having two of this guy is pretty great. Pretty reliable game plan at that point. So, sure. Alright. Well, not a lot. You know, if we are sure we're in blue-red, then probably the best card for us is just Rogue's Passage. But I think the best card in the pack is Maulers. We have been passing a decent amount of green, so there's not really, I don't know. There's no guarantee we're going to actually play this, but unless we want to take Evolving Wilds, the rest of the pack's pretty bad, so I guess we'll take the best card. Okay, so... Probably the best card in the pack is Necromantic Summons, but I haven't really been playing getting any black, so I don't think that's going to be the pick. Prickle Boar is, like, definitely better than Cobble Brute. I see some value to Cobble Brute when I already have two Seismic Elementals. Like, Cobble Brute into that, just guaranteed at least 4 damage is pretty nice. Also, I don't necessarily know that I want million fives, even though Prickle Boar is definitely better than Cobble Brute. But it's a little early to worry about our curve that much compared to just taking the better card. Can also just take Disperse, which I don't love, but maybe it's just the best card for us. Like, we don't really need more fives at this point. Well, so the best card in the pack is Wild Instincts, and there is another good green card in the pack. Chandra's Fury I do like quite a bit. Probably not, again, as necessary when I already have these things. I don't know. It's hard. It's like, I've been seeing some decent green, but there's not really... Like, I've been passing a lot of green, too, so I don't know that I'm necessarily going to end up in green, realistically. I probably not hugely miss the Fury if I just take this. Like, I could probably get another one. Then not a lot in any color, really. I guess I just take Veteran's Sidearm here. Might play it. Yeah, I'll take another Disperse, sure. Is good with Jesse and Thief. Scab Clan, not great, but we have no 2-drop guys yet, so passable. But yeah, like, if you just bounce their guy and attack with Destiny Thief, great. Like, you didn't, you're not actually down a card, so whatever. That's generally when I end up playing Disperse, is when I have Thief. And I don't really want any of this. Pretty unlikely I play that, but sure. Stratus Walk, reasonably likely I play. It's good with these big guys. Alright, well, I still think I'm red. I only have 2 red cards, but they're both so good. I don't know. We'll see what we see next pack. Not going to play Heavy Infantry. Not going to play Brawler's Blade. Alright, well, I would say this card is, like, good, not insane. Mostly because you have to, like, actually get instants and sorceries to play with it. Now, we do already have 2 Disperse, so it's probably going more towards insane than good in our deck. But yeah, like, 3/4/5 is not really, like, the best body in the world or anything. So you have to actually be able to use the abilities. Or at least, I guess the good thing about this card is you can just threaten to use the abilities, and that's often enough. You know, in an alternate universe where we pick the elves, we actually get a Leaf Gilder here, so that could be sweet. But, yeah, in our blue deck, I think we want this. Alright. Well, you know, again, we could be green or we could be red. Our red cards are a lot better than our green cards. And we were passing green, so I doubt we're going to actually see much this pack. But anyway, I think either way, like, so, yeah, if we're green or still not sure, then we take Disperse. But if we want to commit to red, we take Fire Impulse, which is much better than the Disperse. It is definitely the best card in this pack. So I think I'll just take this. I kind of assume we're not in this. Well, I don't really like Drake or Fire Fiend Elemental, though Fire Fiend Elemental does get a little better when I can make it unblockable. Majoring Bully is pretty bad. Like, just having an attack every turn is a pretty huge downside. Call the Full Moon, I have not actually played with, though my teammates seem to like it, so maybe it's probably better than I'm giving it credit for. Yeah, I really don't like either of these cards. I guess Drake's better. Alright. I don't know how many disperses is too many disperses. I'm sure there is a number. So yeah, it's kind of between, like, Owl and Chandra's Fury. Yep, I don't think I want 3 disperses, so I guess I'm going to take an owl. Alright, well, this card is, it's actually gone down, like, in my estimation, because I thought it was just Stand Step Outcast. Well, it is Stand Step Outcast, but, I mean, it's a different format. Like, it is still good, but part of it is there's, like, 3 common red guys that cost 3 that are all just good, so it doesn't matter drastically which ones end up in your deck. But anyway, I'm very happy to see this card. Ooh. This card is great. I think somehow I've never actually had this card. I might have, like, picked it and, like, not ended up in red before. But I do really want to play it, so I'm going to take it here. Ooh, Water Courser. Oh, I almost picked a Water Courser. I didn't even see the Sergeant. Sergeant is better than Water Courser. This card is very good. Another one of the red 3-drops. Well, it's, I guess if I was, like, a super defensive deck, I might want Water Courser more. I shouldn't say it's, like, strictly better, but I think I would rather have Sergeant. Call Brute could be okay in our deck. We have multiple Disperses, Stratus Walk potentially, Seismic Elemental. Though I guess we only have 1 2-drop guy right now, so probably should just not mess around and just make sure we're adding to the board early. Even if it's not a particularly good one. It's hard to get any 2-drops that aren't crappy 2-1s in blue-red, I guess. So Guardian Automaton, perfectly serviceable card. We're also potentially in pack three, like, couldn't end up with, like, whatever the Artifact Lord is, and, you know, blue-red definitely has the most, I guess, all the Thopters, so this is probably the pick. I mean, it's basically between this and Smash as a sideboard card. I really like Aeronaut all that much, but can go in my deck. I'm only going to play either of these counter spells, so I guess I'll just take this card that's, like, good and I don't want other people to have. Like, if I open Thopter Spy Network or something, I'm probably going to want this. And I'm probably not going to side and demolish over at such a bad rate, so. I guess I should just get rid of this blocking part of my deck, sorry. How do you make, how do I make my sideboard bigger? There we go. It's pretty funny, just speculatively take this piece of crap and then open the network. So I have 1, 2, 3 artifacts right now. 4 artifacts, I'll play that other thing. So yeah, I can take this and prioritize artifacts all pack, or I can just take Jesse and Thief, which is just great and doesn't need any help. Not actually sure what's right there. It's probably just Thief. It's like, seems like, eh. You know. Oh, I guess I have Spiring Aeronaut too, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4. I already have like 5. Alright, yeah, I should take network. I don't think it's going to be too hard to get this turned on. Alright, let's see here. Ooh, another thing that makes an artifact. Alright. All going according to plan / luckiness. Alright, well, I'll probably be taking Lightning Javelin just because it's like good in my deck, but this card's reasonably unbeatable. This is so good. I'm not going to hate draft when there's actually a good card for my deck, but I'd consider it if it was just all these other cards that just are bad. Yeah, alright. Now, this is an interesting pick. Void Mage is definitely better than Gearcrafter by quite a bit, but I think I have to take Gearcrafter because I just want my Spy Network to be on. Yeah, I mean, that has to be right. Like, I don't know what the number of artifacts you need for this deck, for the card to be on, but I'm certainly not at a point where it's reliably on, so. Didn't really ever anticipate making that pick, but sure. Alright, well, I don't think I'm realistically playing any of this in my deck. Given the amount of 1/1 flyers I have, this is the card I least want to face. Also, I could side in the gate maybe, but probably not. Yeah, let's take this. Yeah, Starfish is just a great card. I mean, it's possible I'm supposed to take, like, Sigil or Guardians. Let's see, how many artifacts am I at yet? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six. Again, I didn't really ever think I'd be taking a Sigil of Valor over a Sigil Starfish. But it actually seems decent in my deck. I'm going pretty wide with all these stupid 1-1 Thopters. Alright, yeah, I guess we'll do that. Man. Feels very bad and possibly wrong. Not like bad as in it was a bad play, but it, like, does not make me feel good. It makes me feel bad. This is probably why I jump ship on Thopter Spy Network decks so often, because I just hate picking all these cards. Yeah, I don't know that this is reasonably ever going to make my deck. Like, I don't have a lot of ways to attack early. But, I'd probably rather even play the Vial over it. I think I want access to a Chandra's Fury for decks full of 1-1s more than I want a Bonded Construct. I'm hopefully not playing this Warhorn, but sure. Yeah, odds are pretty high I'm not playing any of this. It's a very late rock smallers. Don't think my deck cares that much about Titan Strength. Yeah, whatever. Not too likely to side of negate. I guess there's like a non-zero side in Rambler, but it's probably pretty close to zero. Scabba might actually play. Should have taken that ascetic. That was stupid. That was so stupid. Like, clearly I should take away the kills, like my bomb card. Alright. Well, let's see what we can put together here. Okay, well, definitely have to make some cuts. So let's see how many artifacts we have that we like are pretty sure we want to play. We want to play Veteran Sidearm, Sigil of Valor, the three Gearcrafters, Automaton, and Aeronaut. So that's 5, 6, 7. It's actually not a terrible number. Like, I'm not really trying to play Guardians of Miletus. I don't think my deck can get reasonably aggressive. Doesn't seem necessary. Also, don't necessarily want to play Warhorn and Vile. I might end up playing them. It's just, like, Vile's so low cost that I might just play it. It plays itself immediately and turns on network, so maybe that's, like, correct as play. Stratuswalk, probably not necessary in the deck I ended up in. Well, my worst 3-drop is Drake. So I think the last cards that could potentially come out are take out an owl. We take out one of the scabs. I mean, we do have a lot of stuff to do on turn two. Not that it's not really good stuff, but stuff. Like, we're gonna cast something turn two with all this equipment and stuff and all that, so maybe I don't need scab as much. I mean, it is pretty bad. I mean, I could also see, but the owl might just not be right. I don't know. Our mana is also a little awkward, like double red and double blue. There's like a really early pick where I could have taken a an Evolving Wilds that I wish I took. Yeah, I guess Vile's also like okay with Thief. Yeah, that's Vile should be in our deck. Owl is pretty mediocre. Like, I don't know that I necessarily need more late game, like between network and the elementals and stuff. Also, maybe like scab is okay, like just because we want a lot of guys to like sigil. I don't know. Don't know. Yeah, I don't know. I don't really want to play three of that stupid thing. It's so bad. Let's go with that. Could also play a Volcanic Rambler. That's probably all the regional options. Could play Chandra's Fury, main deck. It's not the worst. Eh, I guess we'll try this. Yeah, 9-8 sounds right in that direction. More blue, just because we have Spy Network and Claustrophobia before we have Seismic Elemental and Ravaging Blaze. Alright, sure.